So let's look at the Flex Connect multicast configuration with AeroOS controllers. So this is the diagram we will basically using, but anyway, the simple idea is one of the AP we will convert into Flex Connect mode, and then we will configure the Flex Connect local switch SSID, and traffic will be terminating locally on the switch number one in our case, and then we will test the multicast using that SSID. So the high level information you need to remember is actually, you know, like if you are using a Flex Connect local switching, so this AP will be not joining the CAPFAP multicast group because data traffic will never go to controller. But if the central switching SSID, you have to do that, you know, like the AP will join the CAPFAP multicast because traffic will be centrally switched. The other important thing to remember is in the IGMP point of view, the wireless controllers typically does not support IGMP v3 properly. So in that way, probably go with IGMP version 2 if you're deploying wireless multicast. The other thing to remember is, you know, like whenever you're converting to Flex Connect, this AP will not maintaining the MGID table, the Flex Connect AP. So because of that, so it will not snoop IGMP membership report and build up that table. So in that way, that is one thing to remember. So upstream switch has to basically deal with that. Every request will be simply forwarding. So with that, just look at, let's go to the controller and see how we configured this. So in the wireless controller, if you look at the AP, what I have done is now actually AP converted into Flex Connect mode. AP is in the Flex Connect status. So the other thing actually in the MR and the Rockstar Multicast SSID. So that SSID, actually you have to enable local switching feature. So that local switching feature is in the advanced tab, we have enabled this. So note that, you know, like that even though now you have configured for local switching, so this setting will be only applicable for Flex Connect mode APs. So in this controller, local mode AP can be there. So they will just ignore this particular setting. They will send the traffic back to controller all the time. But if it's a Flex Connect AP, now Flex Connect AP can do the local switching. So how you configure that in AeroOS world, it is in the Flex Connect group. You need to have a Flex Connect group configuration here. So I have defined something called Rockstar Flex Connect group. So in that particular Flex Connect AP, you have to add your APs. So in my case, that AP already added to this Flex Connect group. The other thing, important thing is in our use case, actually we are only worried about this VLAN mapping, not all other configuration settings. So in that one, actually now we have two VLAN, 130 is the native VLAN on the trunk port. If you want to show, you know, like in the switch, let me just show that particular port. Show run interface gig 1/0/6. So this is configured connecting to that particular AP. So it is native VLAN 130, and we are permitting two VLAN, VLAN 129 and 130. So the native VLAN has to be AP management. It is untagged VLAN. So in that way, whenever you configure in the controller, you need to say, yes, I need the VLAN support, multiple VLAN support, but what is the native VLAN? 130. So that is the one I'm showing there, you know, like it is configured already for VLAN support, native VLAN 130. And then WLAN ID, you need to map to a VLAN. So in that way, what we are saying is whenever the WLAN ID number one, which is the Rockstar Multicast SSID, I have mapped to VLAN 129. So then VLAN 129, the traffic will be now, whenever the client connecting, they should get IP addresses from VLAN 129. So actually I have already connected my Windows client in that particular SSID. If you go to monitor client, you will should be able to see that Windows client is there. This is my Windows client already connected to the this SSID, which I have the acting as the receiver. So now what we will do is actually a couple of things, you know, like just before start, let me just cast group. You can see here it is not there. This is the 225.100, which is my controller multicast group configuration 225.100. So then AP will be not joined that CAPVAP multicast group because it is not required because this is local switching enabled on the SSID, so it is not there. So now what we will do is actually go ahead and enable multicast streaming. Before do that, let me just show the switch to configuration as well. Show IP mRoute 239.168.225.100. Controller is basically sending traffic to this, but again, incoming interface VLAN 225, but outgoing interface is null because no AP join in this CAPVAP multicast group. So in that way, it is not being used, you know, like APs are not joined in this CAPVAP multicast because in my example, I have only the one single AP Flex Connect mode, but it is only configured with the local switching. Show IP mRoute 239.168.225.100. You can see here because this RP, this is already learning about that, but again, it is not going traffic anywhere because there's no interesting client. So even multicast scenario here, you will see this is not being used because even we join the CAPVAP Flex Connect AP here, we should not use any CAPVAP multicast because multicast should not natively flow. So now I have everything here. So I have APs access as well because I will show you some command to verify multicast on the AP. I have the control access here. Everything is ready. So let's go and stream multicast for from this particular source here. So let me just media stream. You go. We will pick the same sort of video and stream. And let's select the RTP-MPEG transport system. So let's use 239, 2.3.7. So in that way, different group, let's say Flex video stream. And no need to activate transporting. We'll put a TTL value of 10. So now this will be streaming. So now if you go to the switches here, so now I am streaming for, again, this multicast group address, you will see nobody interesting yet. So even if I now check the 2.3.7, 2.3.7, it's sourcing from this 100 and outgoing interface is null. Why outgoing interface is null? Because no client interested about this multicast group. So what I can show is actually I will go here and registered for this multicast group here, subscribe for that group address. But the configuration point of view, you remember in the previously we have configured this WLAN for multicast direct feature. So in that way, multicast direct has been enabled. So I have left the, you know, controller global configuration previously we have done. It's remain as it is. So in that way, media stream. So that's already enabled. And streaming point of view, I have something called group address 239.231.29. 239 we have enabled for media stream feature. So in that way, now whenever we do and go and subscribe, even the Flex Connect scenario, we should be able to see the client. So now if we monitor multicast, this is how you see in here, you will see, but actually I have not yet subscribed, you know, like in here, if I go to controller, show the command is actually show Flex Connect media stream client summary. So now you can see there is a one client previously joined when I did the testing, 239.2.3.8, but again, it is not the group address I subscribe for. Okay, so in that way, what I will do is actually I will media open network stream because I previously done testing, that's why it is still there. So let me just go and subscribe for the address we are basically sending traffic. So now I am just subscribing to this particular group address 239.2.3.7. Let's see what's so. Let me just remove from here and starting new. and media open network stream. Let's use you can see, you know, like it will appear here, you know, like now you can see the multicast streaming keys appear here, multicast direct. So at least you can see it is being, let me just minimize this little bit that you can see it clearly. So you can see the video is playing, you know, like now if you want to see whether we are being using the all the spectrum, you can check, you know, like the spectrum. Let me just show that as well. You can see in like this channel being used, you know, like this is 5 GHz channel 52. You can see all this particular channel being used. So that means traffic has to be definitely using the unicast format. So how you can validate the couple of options, you know, you can validate using a packet capture over the air, or otherwise you can do a packet capture, you know, like this is the traffic capturing from this AP connector switch port. I am sending it to Wireshark machine. So if I do a packet capture, so I will basically stop this and recapture here, packet capture, continue without saving. So if I do, now you will see the traffic is going to 2392.3.7. So whenever it goes, you can see if I look at the one packet capture, you know, like this is the traffic going, it is sending to multicast, you know, like the source is our source address, destination is this, it is natively go to this multicast. So in that way, whenever the AP get the traffic, AP get the traffic as a multicast traffic, normally coming from the wired side, but now AP has to convert this to unicast. Okay, so then the initial indication is, you know, like based on the spectrum, we can see this traffic has been channel being well utilized. So then it is should be, that's what this is saying as well. Let me just say now monitor multicast. You can see this is there. Okay, so there it is already being using the multicast direct feature. So now if you want to check, we looked at basically in the AP, you know, like you can use not the AP controller, you can use the show flex connect media stream client summary, and the other detail is, and if you have many different media stream, you can have a detail option as well, but then you need to specify the stream name you are interested. But in our case, we only have one stream, so then we can say this as a different client, because this is the same client. Actually, it is not age out, this is not live client in the same IP. You can say MAC address, you can see it's saying I have subscribed for that address as well, 238. This is the previous testing I have done. But now if you want to go to the AP level, you can check the AP level as well. This is the AP show CapFap multicast. Multicast, there are a couple of options. In our case, this is Flex Connect multicast, which we are interesting. You can say Flex Connect, and again clients, clients option is, you know, like you can check client, it will tell, you know, like it has a multicast to unicast list. You can see multicast unicast list, it listed this particular client, which is my Windows client, and group address is 2392.3.7. so it is saying this is actually multicast to unicast conversion. But this is the previously, you know, like some other previous not aged out client still there, you know, like 238. It is again saying that multicast to unicast, but this client actually not at the moment, you know, like I'm sure this is an aging out issue on the AP. But then there are some other group addresses. You can see 239.255.255.250. It's saying it is a multicast only. That means even my client basically subscribe for this, that traffic may be coming as a native multicast. So in that way, now you know video is playing. So in the keep remember this command, show CapFap multicast Flex Connect client, and if you look the Flex Connect groups, this will tell, you know, like which groups basically we configured, you know, like a certain video or stream feature configured for a couple of groups, this starting IP for this and ending IP with that. So which is we enable that feature only WLAN only one, which is the my first SSID configured in here. So now you saw this and verification. The one final thing what we will do is actually we will go ahead and do some packet capture. So before doing the packet capture, let me just show what I have been doing. You know, like at least I have a that Jetson Nano. In that way I can show. So this one basically now let me just start capture on the channel number 52. What I will do is actually because I would like to get a new client connected using a pre-shared key SSID. So in that way we can decrypt the traffic because this is so what I will do is my I have connected for my now iPad is connected. If you go back here and check monitor client. So now at least I have second client connected. This is the my iPad. But again, if you still look at the monitor multicast, again, you know, previously joined session will be there from my iPad. But again, at least for this particular group, I only have a one client. So still this iPad has not been joined for the new group address. So what I will do is actually let me just show on the here as well, you know, like go to the. You can see, you know, like this is the only Windows client joining this particular group address. So I will go ahead and subscribe for that 2392.3.7 group. So now my iPad also joined the multicast group. So now if you issue the command, you will see that iPad now joining the group. Okay, so that one is also using multicast direct. Even in the AP, if you go and check show CapCap multicast Flex Connect client, you will see now client multicast unicast list. There are two client. Okay, so one client is this, the other client is this address. Both client is basically on VLAN 129. So now even Spectrum should have the similar sort of multiple channel being used. So now that should be captured. So let me just rejoin leaving from the group as well from the iPad. So in that way we don't want to basically. So now I just removing from the group and then I will stop the capture here. So now let me just save this particular file. I will give this particular file. This is a live capture we took. Let me just say Nano X01 Flex Video Stream. This is the PCAP file. So now in here, if you want to look at now, what I'm interesting is actually see whether the over the air how the traffic went. Okay, so one easiest way actually you can filter the traffic IP destination. Send into this multicast group address. Let's see whether we can see that group address traffic in that capture. You can see here, you know, like that traffic being there, you know, like a lot of traffic is there for that particular multicast group address. But if you look at a couple of them, you know, like let's pick one, and this is sending to 2913, which is the if you look at the 2913 should be okay. So let me just see the multicast. 2913 is the iPad. Okay, so the 2913 is the iPad and it subscribe for that group address. This is the traffic sending to that, you know, like if you look at here now 2913, the traffic is destination address goes to individual address, and then QoS control, you will see the traffic has the user priority value. You saw when the AP packet captured the wired connected port, traffic comes with no DHCP value. As a multicast destination address, you know, like that is the Wireshark capture which we had a look shows here. So even the traffic sending without any DHCP value to multicast MAC address. So AP receive these, but when AP receive that, AP will be converting into unicast over the air. So that is pretty much, you know, like Flex Connect scenario. Important thing to remember is now again with that you can see the data rate it is going, you know, like depending on the client, you know, like it is sending the higher data rate, MCS data rate, not like, you know, like it is because it's a AP, it's a VHT 11AC AP, So we will not see like 11 more than close to 1 gig sort of traffic. But you know, like, because now what we will do is actually when we go to the 9800 configuration, we will see the similar sort of configuration on 9800 using 11ax AP. So that's pretty much about the Flex Connect demonstration. So the key takeaways actually APs will be not joining multicast group address, you know, like that way CAPFAP multicast may not be used. Okay, so CAPFAP multicast, let me just show here as well. Previously we looked at show IPM route 239.168.225.100. Still this switch is not joining the CAPFAP multicast address. Why? Because traffic is locally switched. There are no relation with the controller. So in that way, remember, if you are using the Flex Connect local switching, APs will not join the CAPFAP multicast group address. So traffic will flow to the normal like a wired network. So it is not required. Let me just go back to the diagram and explain. Traffic will be coming from the multicast source and natively through your network, and controller will not play a role in the local switching network. But important thing to understand is now AP will be the central point getting the client associated, but it will not keep maintaining this IGMP snooping table. So in that way, the upstream switch AP connected has to basically get the messages and handle the query messages. They will need to make sure they will AP will not able to suppress, you know, like multiple client IGMP reports. All will come here. So whenever you deploy large scale kind of Flex Connect deployment, keep attention for this kind of thing. So it will not, you know, like have the same features like a local mode. So now this is what it is. So probably we will be go for the next. Actually, let's go for the 9800 configuration. So now to be summarized in the ROS, now we have talked about local mode, Flex Connect mode, all this particular scenario. So let's now move into the 9800 multicast.